Dear students, now we are going to discuss the comparison of optical sources, LED and laser. Let's start with the basics of optical sources. Optical source plays a vital role in an optical communication system, especially in an optical transmitter site. It converts an electrical energy into an optical energy. That is, it emits an electromagnetic radiation in the form of light. Light means optical signal. It is also called as optical transducer. Okay. There are different types of optical sources available. Light emitting diode, that is LED, and semiconductor laser diodes. These two optical sources are widely used in optical communication. Okay. The basic requirements of optical sources are given here. The optical source should be compact in size. It provides very high efficiency, good reliability. The light output should be highly directional. It has to couple large amount of power into an optical fiber. The emitting area should be narrower. The optical output power must be directly modulated by varying the input current. Then only we can get high conversion efficiency, okay? The narrow spectral bandwidth. These are the basic requirements, okay? Next, the comparison of LED and laser. LED means light emitting diode. Laser is light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. LED is defined as a semiconductor device which emits light when the current flowing through it. Laser is a device which emits light by the process of optical amplification. Okay. The working principle of LED is based on spontaneous emission, that is electroluminescence process. So when the current flowing through it, it will produce the light signal. That is spontaneous emission. But for this laser, the working principle is based on stimulated emission, okay? The response of the LED is slower than the laser one. Here, laser gives faster response. The nature of light for this LED is incoherent. That means here photons are out of phase. For this laser, it is coherent light. That means all photons are in phase. It is polychromatic signal, that poly represents multiple colors are available in this LED. But for this laser, only one color is available. That is called as monochromatic signal. Here the light beam is divergent one. That is, the light signal is radiating in all directions randomly. But for this laser, it is highly directional. Okay. So the next one is chromaticity, that is multiple colors. Here it is single color. Coherence means photons are out of phase. Here it is in phase. The next one is driving current is in the range of 50 to 100 milliamps. Here it is only 5 to 40 milliamps. Next, bandwidth is in the range of 10 to 50 terahertz. That is wider bandwidth. For this laser, it is narrower, only 1 MHz to 2 MHz. Here the conversion efficiency is very low, around 20%. For this laser, its efficiency is very high, that is around 70%. The numerical aperture value is high for this LED and extremely low for this laser. That is spreading of the light, okay? Next, concentration of charge carriers is very low in LED. Here it is very high. The power consumption, that is less power is required for this LED operation. Here it requires more power. Okay. But the optical output power is low here in LED. For this laser, it is very high output optical power. Okay. The driver circuit in LED is simple, but for this laser is complex. Cost wise, it is low. Laser is high cost. The impact on human eyes. LED is in the considerable range, but laser is not safe for naked eyes. Okay. So we have to careful with this laser. applications of LED. Here, this LED is widely used for commercial applications like indicator lamps, display screens, especially in TV, flashlights, etc. as a commercial applications. In terms of communication, it is used for short distance communication. Laser is used for specific applications like medical surgery, metal cutting, printer, scanner, optical communication, especially for long distance communication. Okay. Next, wavelength parameter. LED is having broader optical spectrum, for example 25 nanometer to 100 nanometer. Laser is having narrower spectrum, that is 0.01 nanometer to 5 nanometer. So these are the example values. Okay. Here the feedback is not required in LED, but for laser feedback is required. This LED is less temperature dependent, but laser is more temperature dependent one. The emission area is wider in LED, but for this laser is narrower and very small in size. Okay, then only we can get coherent light. Okay, and then the fiber type used in this LED is only multimode fiber type. For this laser is single mode and multimode, both can be used. Okay.